Okay, now the third lesson is about the translation of the present perfect tense. Again, the identification that is very important in Urdu. Chuka hai, chuki hai, chuka hoon, chuke hain, ya hai, li hai, or any such type of sentences in which we can find out that the work is completed. Perfect means perfect, something which is completely done. Now here again we'll be using the helping verb, and helping verb in these type of tense would be used as has and have with third form of the verb. Now has or have depends again on your subject. For example, he, she, it would be having the helping verb has, while I, we, they, you will be having the helping verb have. For example, I have written a letter. You can see third form of the verb. You have won the match. They have built a new home. We have forgotten the doctor's name. He has solved the sum. She has recited the poem. It has stopped the rain. So means that subject, then has and have, then third form of verb and object. Now again in the negative sentences we'll be using not after the helping verb, just like we had done in the continuous tense. Subject the hen, then helping verb has, then not for the negative sentences, and late third form of verb, and an egg is the object. So the hen has not laid an egg. I have not read the latest speech of foreign minister. India has not implemented, acted upon on Tashkent declaration. And same is the case with the interrogative sentences, that we will again now bring the helping verb at the start. So instead of the hen has not laid an egg, or we can change it over here also. I have written a letter. We will change it like have I written a letter? Have you won the match? Have they built a new home? Have we forgotten the doctor's name? And so on. So we just has to bring the helping verb at the start, and then our subject, then third form of verb, and then object. Thank you.